Thanks again, everyone, for watching our webcast and supporting U.S. Quidditch today. Please consider making a donation online today. Even a few dollars helps put on events like World Cup. Visit usquidditch.org and click on Donate or follow the link in the comments. Remember that all donations are tax deductible, and every donor who gives $25 or more will receive a special World Cup 8 commemorative coin. And don't forget, at the closing ceremony tonight, we'll be recognizing three teams with Sportsmanship, Best Chant, and Best Uniform Awards. It's up to you to vote for the winners. Pick up ballots to vote at the info booth. Once again, vote for your choice of Sportsmanship, Best Chant, and Best Uniform at the info booth.
like snowball mics.
Yeah,
those are really good mics. They're really cheap.
They're still like them.
I got my friend out for like $40.
That was a lot of
money. Dude, those are probably number like 88 or something.
I'm pretty sure the paying cost is actually
a little snitch.
I would talk to him because I saw him catch it.
You should type it hard.
No, I'm not gonna type stitches.
Either a bolt, the way, slider, or there's a
going down the stairs like this, like sliding.
It fell, and someone in his area brought it. I just,
one of
I don't want the city to loud. Get right there.
One of your, how does that make you feel? Not even. He's crippled. You can't roll dice. You can't roll his D6s. You gotta take drugs to roll his D6s. Huh? I haven't tried.
Obviously. Thank you, Alexis.
I get really bad by
that. Do you type it? Do you
I type like this and I write it. But it's okay because I don't pick up my finger.
Yeah.
Holy crap. This should be.
Okay.
What's with the LG?
Here, I'll pop it.
There you go.
Ha. Watch the servant guys to sleep. I hope that gets trending. But it's World Cup is trending. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Jeez.
I don't know.
Yeah, all the games are going to be on this field. There's three more games.
Oh, that's easy.
Yeah. Driven guy to snitch the final.
We need to keep this serious for you, sir. Thank you.
But no, I think this is Lost Boys. That's not what I told them.
Too late now.
Lost Boys UT?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Lost Boys in Texas.
Yeah, this is Texas.
That's not what I told.
No, yeah, it is. I think they switched it up. Oh, there it is. Last one, UT.
Yeah.
Yeah, last one, UT.
So last year was Texas and Texas State.
Welcome to the family.
Yeah. We got it wrong. I'll take credit.
That's good. That's not out of control anymore. Somebody else.
It's coming over the speakers.
Treat up the tweeters.
Dude, we are our own thing on Snapchat.
What? Really?
Yeah, we are. It's called Our Quidditch Story.
our
we should announce that over the speakers if we can.
Yeah, she.
We are our own event on Snapchat.
Yeah.
That's awesome, Snapchat.
Go to channel 11 and tell the guys down there to do that.
Or
yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah. Warming up. Come on, shake that out. I'm Snapchatting
the
webcast.
Hey, everybody say hi. So, my cousin didn't pick up, but she just texted me back. I'll call you later. So, I don't know if it means she never read the test, but,
that's something at least, so that means you'll have a ride later.
Hopefully. I didn't even know she's going to be able to.
What does that even mean?
She moved recently, like, because she moved out of her apartment somewhere else. So, like, I don't know where in Rock Hill she is. Like, she never told me that part. Like, because I go over to the church every now and then just so like, I can, like, so she remembers that I exist so I can ask her to drive me to Target sometimes.
So
I
say,
like, I don't know her too well, so I'm like, hoping that she'll be okay with me sending a cold calling for a ride.
If worse comes to worse, we can reimburse you for a cab.
I mean, it's fine. I don't mind staying with it. Yeah. Really, all I have, like when I said, all cool stuff. I tend to get.
It shows up everywhere.
I tend to overthink this kind of
awesome
stuff.
Awesome.
Yes. Everyone on Snapchat.
I have like I have 2 weeks left on this paper, but like it drives me crazy if I don't get it done immediately.
That's
like,
to pay your honors.
Yeah. And it's like the same kind of people that like where they were like, oh crap, I gotta get this done because it's due in a day. That's how my brain feels when they assign it.
Yeah.
But it was mainly I had a paper that I was editing or something that technically isn't due until Tuesday, but I just wanted to get it done.
Okay.
But if I'm here till we leave, that's fine.
Yeah.
It's just that I had been hoping to get it done, but really that was just me. But
I don't believe Marquise will be here. I know he'll be back here at some point. I don't know what he's doing, but I'm sure he'll be here at some point.
Yeah.
Here, keep calling him.
Literally,
just use my minutes to call him.
Alright, everybody stop.
Go.
No, move to the left.
There you go.
That was too far. Move back. No, we're still in the middle. Okay, good.
There you go.
I'll be back
in a few minutes. Do you mind just
watching my purse?
Yeah,
no problem.
Yeah.
Go ahead and get on the camera. I'm trying to get the mic.
doesn't
run. Yeah, I understand what the rules are. They're pretty much there to make sure you get the book handed out.
Because he can just do it.
One kid was like swarming over. Just every time someone put a stitch in,
ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. If you are sitting around the field for this semifinal matchup, we ask that you take a few steps back away from the white line. If everybody would scoot back just a smidge off the white line to make sure that no ball or player or spectator gets hurt. Thank you.
Everybody just dies.
Ryan said a smidge. A smidge meaning about 2 or 3 feet. Probably more along the 3 foot side.
Actually, no,
we just don't want anything to be a question.
Usually what I do.
That's standard smidge.
I watch the live game. And then move back over here and see if there's a score here with the flag. And then I move back.
How behind you? It's like a what, 3 second delay? Yeah, look.
We're not that favorite. But everything else we try.
Is it okay if I post this on Snapchat?
This is like.
But it's World Cup 8 now, I think. So I figured I'd post it.
Yeah, why not?
Awesome.
Take another one and go up and smile next time.
Okay, we'll take another one.
So, like, if you go do it in the HUD, the HUD shows up.
Am I in this?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. Say cheese.
Just about to get our first Final Four matchup underway. This is going to be Texas taking on the Lost Boys from California. Once again, I am Brad Wozniacki, and alongside me is Joey Dennis. Here we go with the Final Four. Brooms up here on Carlisle Field in Rock Hill, South Carolina.
That's right. It is a great time for this. Well, great weather for this. And Texas taking care of the Quaffle and the Bludgers pretty convincingly in that one. The same strategy in getting some fast breakers for the kickoff to get that control.
Lost Boys get the stop first on the first offensive possession for Texas. Talking about how these two teams got here throughout bracket play today. Texas, a 150-70 win over the LA Gambits in the round of 16. Then in the Elite Eight, Texas defeated Blue Mountain Quidditch Club 100-20. And for Lost Boys, they started out the day with a win in the Sweet 16, doubling up University of Virginia 200-100. And then in the Elite Eight matchup, it was Lost Boys defeating Arizona 170-100. That brings us to our first Final Four matchup. The other two teams in the Final Four will be the University of Maryland and Lone Star. So the dream's still alive for Texas to try and three-peat.
Oh, absolutely. It's very much alive, and especially being the first ones on the board. But,
Lost Boys couldn't get on the board that time. Nearly tied this one up at a goal apiece.
Yeah, they, interestingly enough, last game it was University of Texas knocking out the Gambits in a wonderful game. This time, actually taking on a team formed by the same people as the LA Gambits.
And now Texas has made it 2 goals. 20-0. Scoring that one was Nicholas Marino.
Pulling some great plays from the beaters on side of the Lost Boys, getting that Bludger control back.
The lights have been turned on for our first Final Four matchup, and you can certainly see the crowd of teams and spectators around Carlisle Field. It's a packed house where we will have both semifinal matchups. And there's the stop. Once again, Maryland can't get on the board. Reaching up to take that one down was the keeper, number 21, David Ackert.
Hager with a fantastic leap there.
Texas looking to make it a three-goal lead. The Bludger is kicked away, but it's still Bludger control for the Lost Boys. As Texas is looking to try and create some space, and Merrill just pushing them back towards their own goal.
You don't see that very often, Texas getting too pressured to even stay at half pitch.
Wanted a nothing our score. Texas with possession. Texas, of course, in their orange uniforms, and the Lost Boys in the black and red. This is a team, the Lost Boys, that we've been impressed with throughout the entire World Cup. No surprise that they are where they are right now. Now the Bludger play in front, trying to clear some space, but Texas never got it forward.
Excellent beats.
Now a chance for Texas to fake the score. Once again, that is Nicholas Marino. Now we have a stoppage in play. Brooms are down.
This might actually be about being beat before the goal. Still standing. Texas with a somewhat dominating performance at the moment.
Once again, brooms are down.
Immediate yellow card for number 17. That was contact from behind.
Lost Boys, still scoreless, but now a chance in front. Good Bludger play, and there's the first goal for the Lost Boys. That's got the crowd pumped up. Scoring that one, number 10, Alex Brown.
As soon as they got on the board.
See if that ignites the offense for the Lost Boys, who had a couple of opportunities just moments ago to get that first goal, but they finally capitalized.
Yeah, that's fantastic for them.
Now the quaffle loose. Now scooped up, but Bludger play is going to give it to the Lost Boys, unless Texas can recover, but once again, good Bludger play from the Lost Boys.
Bludger play has been very, very intense in this game.
We started this World Cup with 80 teams. You think back to 2007, when the first World Cup of Quidditch started, we had just two teams. Took place at Middlebury College. We've grown from 2 to 80. The Swiss format this year for Quidditch World Cup here in Rock Hill, South Carolina.
And it's grown so quickly. Oh, and some great beats coming out of number 17 now that he's back into play after that goal.
30 to 10, our score, Texas in front. And the Bludger play up front. The toss, ooh, and the score. Another one for Texas, Augustine Monroe.
Another one for Monroe. Great use of the single Bludger to distract both beaters on that play, though.
Lost Boys tried to respond. Now the Bludger play ends that. Look to be number 22, Martin Bermudez, who came in with the Bludger and then scooped up the quaffle.
Smart to slow down the play. If he went for that quick fast break, he had two very fine beaters waiting for him on that one.
This is Monroe again. And Monroe hit by the Bludger. Got rid of the quaffle, though, to Chilton. And Texas is going to reset back in their own zone.
Excellent job of keeping the pressure on to University of Texas.
This has been rolling a little bit high that time on the shot attempt. But the rebound, and it's put home.
Excellent.
That's Bermudez,
shot.
Number 22.
50-10, Texas lead.
A four-goal lead for the two-time defending champs.
The University of Texas is looking to almost single-handedly take California out of this tournament.
The snitch is working his way around the pitch, getting the crowd fired up.
Probably trying to pump himself up a little bit.
We are down to two teams from Texas with the University of Texas and Lone Star in the Final Four. And we have the Lost Boys from California and the University of Maryland. Quaffles loose, Bludger play. And it's Chilton picking it up for Texas.
This game's snitch is Dakota Briggs. He hails from Utah.
It has just been announced that the snitch for our first Final Four game is Dakota Briggs from Utah.
He had an even longer trip here than I did.
That explains the Utah Jazz jersey that we saw yesterday, along with the cornrows.
That would make sense. You know, and now that I say that, both of these teams have traveled the entire way across the country, so who am I from St. Louis?
Now, I don't know if the cornrows have anything to do with Utah, but we certainly know that the jersey did
the
yesterday.
Jersey did. Well, you know, I'm sure they're coming back somewhere. Why not Utah?
While we have a moment, a reminder that at closing ceremony tonight, we'll be recognizing three teams with sportsmanship, best chant, and best uniform awards. It's up to you to vote for the winners. Pick up ballots to vote at the info booth. Once again, vote for your choice of sportsmanship, best chant, and best uniform at the info booth.
It looks like they're going to need to sub a keeper in right there.
Alex Brown walking towards his bench. If you're the Lost Boys, you cannot afford to lose a player like Alex Brown. Has been one of your top scorers throughout the World Cup.
Yeah, absolutely not. But it does look like he should be all right. He did walk off fairly confident. Just some time off would be good. Ooh.
This is
a little bit of miscommunication there, having both of your beaters run downfield.
Lost Boy is going to walk it up the pitch. Brandon Scapa passes it over to the new keeper. Now Scapa is going to have a chance. Scapa making his way to the outside, looking for some help. And looks as though we may have a penalty coming up here. Was away from the play.
That's going to be a yellow card. Contact from behind.
The Lost Boys will have possession of the quaffle and a chance to make this a three-goal game. No, it is going to be a turnover, so Texas will take over. Unfortunate for the Lost Boys, who were in scoring territory. And now it's off to the races. Texas dominating. No way the Lost Boys are going to catch them. It's a five-goal lead, 60-10 our score. No surprise, it's Monroe putting it home for Texas.
And he is having a great day. He's been having a great tournament personally. Obviously, University of Texas dominating performances all around.
Bludger play up front. Lost Boys going to try and go up the middle. They've got a chance here. Only one Bludger ahead. But Monroe, the keeper, steps in front, takes that quaffle away.
Goes for a fast break. Oh, a pass.
Pass thrown a little bit behind Marino.
They slowed down to let him reset. Monroe now.
Oh, what a feed!
And that was a fantastic pass.
Nobody on the backside except for Texas's very own Casey Irwin. Six goal lead. And once again, a good job by Texas on their bludger play, and Texas is just going to continue to push. Big number 54 with it, Austin Dixon.
Dixon backs off a little bit, seeing that it's a little too much pressure. Tosses it up and over.
Yeah, toss behind the goal. Nearly a takedown, still towards the goal. It's going to be another chance for Texas. And Brooms are down, at least for the moment. Somehow saw Casey Irwin get that pass to Ryan Davis. A Longhorn chance here at Carlisle Field, as it is another goal for Texas, 80-10 our score.
You know, Wolfsburgs have been doing a great job this tournament, but the problem is that they've been making everybody play their game. University of Texas doesn't get pushed around like that, and they've got to figure out a way to adjust their play style to the defense and the offense of the University of Texas.
And a block at the goal. Another stop by Texas. Defensively and offensively, it's all Texas, and off to the races for another score. David Acker.
Acker once again. The keepers have been pretty active in the for the scoring of University of Texas.
And the bludger play.
Lee looking for a call there.
Peter Lee, ring number zero for the Lost Boys, looking for that call. Good to see back on the field is Alex Brown for the Lost Boys.
Absolutely. Every once in a while you just need to catch your breath. Some fantastic aggressive defense.
Oh, look at the quick moves to get to the goal. Wow. Putting that one home for the Longhorns. Aaron Godasi.
Now that was some fancy footwork.
100-10 our scores. That bludger is thrown in the air. High in the air.
That bludger just took off.
Tons of aggression coming out of our beaters right now.
Lost Boys desperately need a goal, but it's stopped. Acker got his hand on it, the keeper for Texas.
Great defense from Acker.
5 minutes to see your floor.
You can see the Lost Boys just having to work so hard just to get back on defense so that Texas doesn't put another one on the board. You know, you get the sense, you know, from us talking that it's all Texas, and you look at the scoreboard, it is all Texas.
As a matter of fact, it is.
At this point, the Lost Boys
at this point,
well out of
I
that.
Do think that the correct play for the Lost Boys would be to man up.
Brown down the sideline. He's got one man to beat. And there's the second goal for the Lost Boys. 100-20.
Great job. Hopefully that invigorates him a little bit.
Brown has his second goal here in the World Cup Final Four.
I do think it would be a good idea for the Lost Boys to actually stack each man in the defense, because their formations are getting picked apart, as we see on the board.
Marino with it, a collision near the goal. A bludger play, just one of the Texas players having some fun. And another score, that's Marino. clipping that one off the rim.
Although the crowd wasn't happy that they did give the Bludger back to Texas, she did have the Bludger in her hands while she was tagging the post. So it was a fair call, just not a very satisfying one for the crowd, apparently.
That was Sarah Ballister getting rid of it. Excuse me, Ballister.
Go a little low.
90-point lead for Texas as the Lost Boys just missed their third goal.
Yeah. You gotta dismount. You gotta dismount. Yeah, you can keep your hand on the hill. But you gotta dismount.
But you can keep your hand. Monroe on the right side. Finds a teammate, and that one is dunked home. Two-hand slam.
120-20.
That was a classic play. I was trying to figure out where the Bludgers were. Texas has control at the moment.
Scoring that last one for Texas was number 14, Brela Vest. The other way, and as Monroe C, he could have passed it forward, but he wasn't aware of his teammate.
Augustine just getting beat there.
A 100-point lead for Texas, 120-20 our score. Bludgers are all over the place right now. Now Texas will regain Bludger control.
Pace going
and
for a fast
nobody
break.
Back.
Nothing there.
Texas with one more as that one is just laid home. Hayden Pace. The largest lead for Texas. They're well on their way to the final. Now the snitches come onto the pitch.
Pull your shirt down.
And a chance from the audience about Pace's decision for a Philly jersey to pull his shirt down.
I'll leave that one to you.
I mean, it's all in good fun, and as long as he's confident about it, I got no problems with it.
The third goal, it's Scapa scoring that one. Lost Boys still trail by 100. Snitch will be loose in a moment.
And the Seekers have been released.
Here we go. The first Seeker for Texas is William King.
And the snitch taking a running approach.
I gotta try and wear down King.
Snitch has his back up now.
Bludger play coming in. It's going to be King able to go right back at the snitch. The Seeker currently for the Lost Boys is number 93, Griffin Conlog.
Slow down offense here. Being kept safe by their beater. They did get control back while we were watching the snitch, however. Ooh.
That pass too high.
Nobody home when the attempt assist.
That's going to go right to Monroe.
Oh.
So, a good pass. Right in, very clean.
Drive and a goal for Texas.
Texas pushes their lead back to 11 goals.
Lost Boys being a little headstrong here, not really changing up the strategy, just trying to play harder.
Evan Carr is the new seeker for Texas. The fans trying to give the Lost Boys some encouragement. Alex Brown tossed that one over the goal. Might have been trying to pass it.
Oh, and a good attempt at a reset. But
here's Marino.
Go for a fast break.
It's gonna, Monroe, and only had one man to beat, Brown, the keeper, and he did that. The largest lead for Texas, now 120 points.
Interestingly enough, now that Acker's in, it's no longer true, but Monroe and Brown have the same number jersey. Something about that number 10.
The leadership from the number 10. Evan Carr continuing to work hard against the snitch. It's basically one on two with Conlog in there for the Lost Boys.
And switch end is a
new seeker coming in for Texas.
Let them take a breather, see if they can get anywhere.
It's one-on-one right now, and nearly a snitch grab.
Some good one-on-one time.
William King back out there.
And it looks like the Lost Boys are taking time to worry about their defense more than the defense of the snitch.
What a good effort by King as he chases the snitch. Snitch wants the crowd to get into it.
Just feeding off their energy a little bit, I'm sure.
Nearly a snitch grab as the snitch hit the pitch. Boffle being controlled right now by Texas.
Just resetting back just to see if they can get a better position.
Evan Carr is back out there for Texas. Tried for the snitch grab, unsuccessful. It's a pretty even matchup here. You don't see the length that you've seen from other snitches.
That's right.
As Briggs the snitch hits the pitch again.
He's definitely a lot faster than a lot of the snitches we've seen, though. A lot of the snitches prefer to take like a grappling approach and deal with the seekers as they come. This one likes to run across the pitch a little bit more.
Lost Boys have control of the quaffle. It's Brown with it. Bludger play from Texas.
Oh, waffles loose. Communication there on the pass.
And Carr signaling for some bludger help so he can go one on one with the snitch. And there it is. So Carr's going to go one on one. Carr reaching. Nearly had the snitch.
Everybody in the audience is watching with their held breath.
You hear the encouragement from the Texas bench for Evan Carr to try and snatch the snitch.
Oh, absolutely. And if you're Texas, you're feeling pretty confident right now. But Lost Boys aren't out of it yet because the game isn't over.
Carr working hard. And nearly a snitch grab as Briggs hits the pitch. The new seeker for the Lost Boys is number 5. That is Michael Cassier. And there's the snitch grab.
Wow. Right there.
We'll wait for the official word, but nothing short of a dominant performance for Texas. And that's it.
The catch is good.
The snitch grab by, I believe it was Evan Carr, the last seeker for Texas, and it was. That's going to be a 180-30 win in a Final Four matchup for Texas. They're headed back to the final.
Yes, they are. You don't see that very often, but even if with that score difference, the Lost Boys can go home so happy. Being the last four of 80 teams at World Cup, really showing that they are some of the best in the league.
Our next Final Four matchup, University of Maryland versus Lone Star. Could we have an all-Texas final again, or will Maryland surprise a lot of the spectators and the teams here in Rock Hill and get into the final?
Yeah.
We'll find out here on the U.S. Quidditch live stream. Once again, congratulations to the Lost Boys on a great effort to get to the Final Four here at World Cup 8. But it's Texas moving on to the final. Stay with us here on the U.S. Quidditch live stream.
24 minutes, 22 seconds.